Hello students, welcome to lecture number 2. In the previous lecture, we have seen an introduction to communication. In this lecture, we will see the process of modulation and then we will see the different signals involved in modulation. Then we will see the basic definition of modulation and the different types of modulation. And at the end, we will see the need or advantages of modulation. So first, coming to the process of modulation, in modulation, first we have the input signal. So this is the input signal. This input signal is given to the system. Now, this input signal is a low frequency signal, as we have discussed in the previous lecture. This input signal has to be modulated. In the process of modulation, another signal, which is called as carrier signal. Is given to the system, and this carrier signal and input signal both superimpose, both mix together, and suppose this is the antenna. And those both the signals mix together and they are transmitted through the antenna, and this signal is received by a receiver antenna. So the signal which is superimposition of carrier signal and the input signal is called as modulated signal. Now, in talking in terms of the frequency, this input signal is a low frequency signal. It's a low frequency signal, whereas the carrier signal is a high frequency signal. So, both high frequency and low frequency signal are mixed and we get a modulated signal, and this modulated signal is again a high frequency signal. And this input signal is also called as message signal. It's called as message signal. The reason is, this is the message which we want to transmit from this transmitting antenna to the receiving antenna. So this is also called as message signal. And this is also called as modulating signal. The reason why this input signal is called as modulating signal is, this carrier signal is modulated, this carrier signal is modulated in accordance with the input signal or message signal. So that's why this is called as modulating signal, because this signal is modulating the carrier signal. So actually, in the process of modulation, so this carrier signal characteristic, either amplitude, frequency or phase, is changed in accordance with the input signal to get the modulated signal. So in the process of modulation, first we have the input signal which is given to the system, and a carrier signal is added to the input signal, and now this carrier signal carries the message. And the superposition of carrier signal and input signal is called as modulated signal, and this modulated signal is transmitted through the transmitter antenna and it is received by the receiver antenna. So if you see here in this process, three types of signals or waves are involved. The first one is the modulating signal. See, the modulating signal is nothing but the input signal, or it is also called as message signal, because this is the message which we want to transmit. The message can be anything. It can be audio or video. And the next type of signal which is involved is the carrier signal. So this carrier signal is a high frequency signal and it will be having a constant amplitude. So it's a high frequency signal. It's a high frequency signal with constant amplitude. With constant amplitude, and phase. So carrier signal will be having a constant amplitude and a constant phase. And the modulated signal, so this is the modulated signal, the output of this system is the modulated signal. So this is the superposition of the carrier signal and the input signal. So this is the process of modulation and the three types of waves or signals which are involved in the process of modulation. Now coming to the basic definition of modulation. The definition of modulation is, it is a process. It's a process of changing some characteristic of the wave. So the characteristic may be amplitude or frequency or phase. So it's a process of changing some characteristic. That characteristic can be amplitude, frequency or phase of carrier signal. So in the process of modulation, the amplitude or frequency or phase of carrier signal is changed in accordance with the modulating wave. So this is the basic definition of modulation. Now depending on the type of characteristics which we change of the carrier signal, there are three types of modulation. If we are changing the amplitude, then it's called as amplitude modulation or AM for short. If you are changing the frequency, then it's called as frequency modulation or FM for short. And if you are changing the phase modulation or angle, actually it's called as angle modulation. So that will be called as phase modulation. In the case of amplitude modulation, the amplitude is changed. Amplitude is changed, whereas frequency and phase is constant. So the amplitude of the carrier signal is changed in amplitude modulation. In frequency modulation, the frequency of the carrier signal is changed in accordance with the modulating signal, whereas the phase and amplitude remains constant. In the phase modulation, the phase of the carrier signal is changed in accordance with the modulating signal. So these are the three types of modulations. Next, let us see what is the need of modulation. Why do we want to modulate the signal? Is it not necessary that whatever the input signal is there, which is of low frequency, is it not necessary? Is it not sufficient to transmit the data using this input signal? So what is the need of modulation, or what are the advantages of modulation? Now let us see the need of modulation or the advantages of modulation. So why do we need to modulate the signal? Why we should change the characteristics of the signal? Why we need to change the amplitude or frequency or phase of the signal? So what is the need of modulation? Why is it not sufficient for the audio signal to get transmitted from one point to another point? So what is the reason for the process of modulation? So there are four reasons or four needs or four advantages of modulation. The first one is practical antenna length. The second one is interference or mixing of signals is reduced by modulation. The third one is multiplexing can be achieved by modulation. Fourth one is, because of modulation technique, long distance communication is possible. So let us see in detail one by one. First one, practical antenna length. So antenna, so we have two types of antenna. One is the transmitting antenna and the other one is the receiver antenna. So the function of antenna is to transmit and receive the signals. Now according to the antenna theory, height of the transmitting antenna or receiving antenna, according to antenna theory, that the height should be proportional to lambda by 4. So this is called as quarter wave. So not going into detail of all these things. So height should be equal to lambda by 4, where lambda is the wavelength of the transmitting signal. Now let us find out what should be the height of an antenna to transmit an audio signal. So the range of audio signal is from 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz. So it's 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz. So this is the range of audio signal. So let us suppose I want to transmit an audio signal of frequency 10 kilohertz. So let us see what should be the height of the antenna to transmit an audio signal of frequency 10 kilohertz. So first let us find out the wavelength of this wave of frequency 10 kilohertz. So we know that lambda is C by frequency, and that is, therefore lambda is equal to C by frequency, and let us substitute the values. C is the speed of light, that is 3 into 10 to the power of 8 meter per second, and the frequency is 10 kilohertz, so that is 10 into 10 to the power of 3. Kilo is 10 to the power of 3. So if you see this one, so this will become 0.3 into 10 to the power of 5, and this will become 3 into 10 to the power of 4, so that will be 30,000 meters. So the wavelength of this wave which we are intending to transmit of frequency 10 kilohertz comes out to be 30,000 meter. Now let us find out what should be the height of the antenna to transmit an audio signal of this wavelength. And we know that height of the antenna is given by h is equal to lambda by 4. So that will be 30,000 divided by 4, and that turns out to be 7,500 meters. And in terms of kilometer, so this will be h is equal to 7.5 kilometer. So we can see here. So just to transmit an audio signal of frequency 10 kilohertz, antenna of height 7.5 kilometer is required. Now the question is it practical to construct an antenna of 7.5 kilometer? Look at the dimension, 7.5 kilometer. Let me tell you, the Statue of Unity is just 182 meters. It is just 182 meters. So if the process of modulation was not there, if the technique of modulation was not there, then look at the practical difficulty. Just to transmit an audio signal of 10 kilohertz, we will be requiring an antenna of height 7.5 kilometer. So if the process of modulation was not there, imagine if you are standing on the roof of your house, and what will be the cityscape? So the cityscape will be antennas of height around some 7 to 10 kilometers. So is it practically possible? So it's not practically possible. So to make the practical antenna length, we go for the technique of modulation. So in the technique of modulation, what we do? We increase the frequency of input signal. Now let us increase the frequency of input signal and find out what is the antenna length. So let us say that this signal is modulated. This signal is modulated to a frequency of, for simplicity, let me take 3 megahertz. So now this signal, input signal, audio signal is modulated, that is its frequency is changed from 10 kilohertz to 3 megahertz. So this is kilo, this is mega. And now let us find out what will be the height of the antenna to transmit the audio signal of this frequency. Again, we will follow the same procedure. First, we will find out the lambda. So lambda is C by F. So that is 3 into 10 to the power of 8 divided by the frequency is 3 megahertz. So 3 into mega is 10 to the power of 6. So what we get? 10 to the power of 8 by 10 to the power of 6 is 10 to the power of 2. So we get 100 meters. So now the wavelength of the modulated signal is 100 meters. Now let us calculate the height of the antenna required to transmit the modulated signal of wavelength 100 meter. So the height of the antenna is given by h is equal to lambda by 4. So that is 100 divided by 4. So that is 25 meters. So now the question is, constructing an antenna of height 25 meter is practical or not? In the earlier case, we got that the height of the antenna should be 7.5 kilometer, but in this case we got that the height of the antenna should be 25 meters. So what we understand is, so it's practical to construct a 25 meter height antenna, and whatever the antennas we are seeing, all of them are having the dimension or height equal to this value, 25 meters. So what do we understand? So to transmit a low frequency signal, an antenna of very high height is required, whereas to transmit a signal of high frequency, a practical antenna length is required. So this is the first advantage. This is the first advantage of the technique of modulation. So the technique of modulation makes us, or it gives us, a convenient height to construct the antenna to transmit the signals. The second need of modulation, or second advantage of modulation, is, so by the technique of modulation, interference or mixing of signals can be reduced. Interference or mixing of signals can be reduced. So suppose if we are having point A and point B, and we want to send, we are having only one channel. We are having only one channel from A to B, or we are having only one wire from A to B. So now we want to send an audio signal as well as video signal from point A to point B through the same channel. Now let us see the range of the audio signal is 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz, whereas range of video signal is from some 0 megahertz or 0 hertz to some 5 megahertz. Okay, so our task is to transmit both audio and video signals in the same channel from A to B. And suppose if you transmit the audio and video signals in the same channel, so what happens is, in these both signals, both audio and video signals, there are some frequencies which are common to both. For example, if I take an video signal of 30 hertz, so 30 hertz is common to this range as well as this range. If I take an audio signal of say 50 hertz, then that 50 hertz signal is common to both audio range as well as video range. So now what happens is, if there are common frequencies, both the frequencies mix, they interfere. So now at the receiving end, so the person gets confused. He gets a signal which is a mixture of both the signals. So there will be an interference. Now what can be done? How this problem can be avoided? So what we can do is, we can modulate the audio signal and we can modulate the video signal. So we can change the frequency of audio signal, and we can change the frequency or increase the frequencies of audio and video signals, and allot different frequency range for audio signal and different frequency range for the video signals. So we can allot a range, that from this range to this range will be the audio signal, and from this range to this range will be the video signal. So now what happens is, so there will be no common frequencies between audio signal and video signal. So easily we can transmit both the audio signals and video signals through the same channel without the signals getting interfered. The reason is because they will be not having the common frequencies. And this is what we see in the broadcasting stations. So if you look at the various FM channels, the Radio City has got the frequency range of 91.1 megahertz. And whereas the Big FM, it is having 92.7 megahertz. And Red FM, it is having 93.5 megahertz. And if you look at the Bijapur City Akashwani, it is 101.8 megahertz. So we can see here, different frequency ranges are allotted to different broadcasting stations so that there will be no problem of interference or mixing of the signals. So due to the technique of modulation, interference of signals or mixing of signals can be reduced. Now the third is, due to the technique of modulation, multiplexing can be achieved. Multiplexing means sending different types of signals through a single channel. So that's called as multiplexing. And we have seen in point number 2 that here both different types of signals like audio signal and video signal were sent through a single channel AV, through a single wire. So this is possible because of the technique of modulation. Now the last one is, because of modulation, long distance communication is possible. And we know that suppose if I, whatever I am speaking, so my voice is not audible to another city, means to Bangalore, it's not audible. The reason is, the signal whichever I am giving out, the audio signal, it is very low frequency signal and its power is very low and it cannot travel such a long distance. So in the transmission, what we have is, the power transmitted is directly proportional to square of the frequency. So the extent to which a signal can be transmitted depends on the power radiated by the antenna. And the relation between power and the frequency is, power is directly proportional to square of the frequency. So what we understand from this relation is, if the frequency is more, then the power radiated is more. So if we use high frequency transmission, then the power radiated will be more and the signal can travel to a long distance. Whereas if we use a low frequency signal, then the power radiated will be low and the extent to which the power transmitted will be low.